Classic Game Room HD, we usually review the classics like Revenge of Shinobi and Ms. Pac-Man. But if you're playing Frogger and you feel like it's too constraining, like it's not open-ended enough, you can't just go berserk and carjack the people trying to run you over, then jump their car into the river, machine gun the alligators, and then blow up a bunch of other stuff, then maybe it's time to play Grand Theft Auto 4. I mean, holy shit, I didn't even know this was possible. I've been playing the Grand Theft Auto series since the first one, and this just blows my mind. This is everything that I expected it to be, at least from a technical standpoint. This is a two-part review, and I'll get into the storyline more in the second part. It looks promising. I wanted to see what the controls and the environment were like, and I am just unbelievably impressed. This is quite simply the finest looking, finest handling, most open-ended video game I've ever seen in my life. And what you're looking at on screen is just the tip of the iceberg.
A ton of alcohol and drug abuse.
The great music and the sense of humor in the radio stations that made the GTA series a classic from the beginning are here again. We have another huge selection of musical songs from big artists. Got some Queen in there and REM. I opened the episode with the Queen song that was used in Iron Eagle, an excellent movie that you should all see, because 80s rock, F-16s, and cassette players all go together so well. The firing system is pretty nice. You can lock on to targets. I was playing this on the Xbox 360. Holding the left trigger down halfway allows you to aim at anything. I wanted to see what happened when I started trying to shoot people in the knee. You can shoot out car windows. You can do pretty much anything in this game that you probably shouldn't do in real life. And that's why we play Grand Theft Auto. The variety and the realism of the automobiles and other vehicles that you get to drive around is just stunning. We have replicas of Escalades, Camaros, BMWs, Mercedes. They all handle differently, and it drives pretty much like Forza 2 on the Xbox 360 if you're used to that. This game is also on PlayStation 3. I haven't tested that version yet. I haven't really gotten into the weapon selection much, but when you steal the cop cars, you do come away with a free shotgun. And if you get blown up or gunned down and go to the hospital, you do retain your weapons. So that's a nice thing. We're in Liberty City for this game, which is just the most photorealistic, amazing recreation of New York City. The game comes with a huge map, and you can see some of the great icons, the Brooklyn Bridge, which they've renamed the Broker Bridge. I like that you can drive over to the 1939 and 1964 World's Fair fairgrounds.
There's nowhere to go! We have you!
This is really just a preliminary review, giving you a taste of Grand Theft Auto 4. There's clearly much more to this game than just exploring the environment and destroying the cop cars, but if that's all that there was to this game, it would still be entertaining. The recreation of New York City also has many different islands connected by bridges, and as you progress in the game, you unlock the bridges. At this point, I've only just started. I can't get over the bridges and get over into Manhattan, for instance. In conclusion, I like video games like River Raid on the Atari 2600, but sometimes I just want to get out of that jet flying down the river, get on foot, hijack some of those battleships, crash them into the houses, steal their stuff, and have a great story with a great sense of humor all wrapped around it. And that's Grand Theft Auto 4. Now we got a little black party, y'all. It ain't man but any Bacardi, y'all. Sitting on the stoop, on a milk crate. How you living life? Say great, great. We all came from nothing into something, something. Why these niggas hating? Why these niggas fronting? We just riding with our tops down. Niggas acting crazy. Somebody got shot now. Riding with my top down, and my jury on. Hey, I'm just getting my hood on.